Well, amen.
Right.
Make sure.
One, two, yes. Make sure I'm on. Some people want to turn me off, so I'm sorry. Aren't you glad to live in a country where we can praise the Lord without somebody coming in and stopping us? I'm so thankful. Thankful for your church, this church's prayer for Rhonda. You're really blessed today, and I'm really blessed. This, we got Tuesday, she has her fourth chemo treatment. Or excuse me, your fifth chemo treatment. And just a few days prior to that, she's feeling the best she's felt from the last chemo treatment. And then Tuesday, she'll feel good for 2 days, and then she'll go down the hill and be weak. And we just need your prayers. And she came with me last night up here, and we tested out the microphones and sang them. She said, you know, I think I can see.
Bless her heart.
Amen.
So she's going to join me in just a minute, but I think it would be appropriate for us to sing God Bless the USA. You can sing with me this morning. If all the things were gold I'd worked for all my life, and I had to start again, just my children and my wife. I thank the Lord above to be living here today, cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. I'm proud to be an American where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the man who died. Anything goes. I thank God for America.
Yes, sir.
To have the freedom to worship my Savior, amen. Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I don't care what they say. I thank God for our president making the statement that this country will never be a socialist country. But Christian people better stand up, start standing up for the facts. Standing up for what you believe. Don't give in to everybody else because they want to do it a different way. Change our values, taking God we trust off of our coins, and as our nation's motto. It'll break your heart. And I'm fearful for America. Because I pray God's going to take judgment out. Because we've neglected Him, taking Him out of our schools, taking how many thousand innocent babies have been aborted. And you know what? When they get to where they can take a baby out of the womb and decide whether they're going to let it live or not. It won't be long. They'll be coming to the nursing homes and decide whether you have the right to exist until God calls you home. Church, we have to stand up, start being the church. Hallelujah. Pastor, I'm sorry for taking up time, but I just have to test if I'm so blessed. And I'm not going to give up, and I'm not going to let the devil win over my life. And you can stand with me if you want to. Sing the Lord's praise. Well, I'm not giving up. I'm not turning around. By the grace of God. come together and be what God has called us to be. And now Rhonda's gonna come help me. And if she can stand, if she can't stand, I got a stool here for her to sit on.
That's fine. Bless her heart.
Amen.
Bless her heart.
Praise God, we're not gonna give up. We're gonna sing the song. We don't necessarily have all the words down. And that's okay. I love to have them all memorized. I don't know. Some of you, the older I get, harder it is to remember words. I'll go back upstairs and find out what I came downstairs for. But I'm so glad we have a Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Amen.
I said, I'm glad we got a Heavenly Father.
Amen.
He loves us.
Yes.
And we're not perfect. We mess up. We fail. But you know what? He's always ready to reach his hand down and say, come on.
Yep.
I'm going to lift you up. You're going to make it. Don't give up. Come on. Let's make it. Hallelujah.
Sometimes birds are heavy to carry, sent me down to my knees. In the Lord's presence, humble and tarry, wait for victory. As I look upward into his glory, troubles all fade from view. And the sweet voice says, child, rejoice, I'm watching.
She's going to make it through these last treatments. The doctor said they get harder. But I tell you what, We just gonna start praying for more strength from the Lord to make it through. I don't want this cancer coming back. She's been battling it 3 different times. This is the 3rd time, and I don't want to go through it again. I want to go on to heaven the next time. We're not gonna wait for the chemo. We're gonna make it to 99 years old. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Oh, man. You want to say something before you sing this song?
Bless her heart.
Bless her, Lord.
If I can. God's been very faithful. It's been probably the hardest battle I've ever been through.
Yeah, for Lord.
But I know that God's going to keep me and he's going to take me through this. The devil wants to come beat you up. He wants to tell you, no, you're not. You're not going to make it. So I just pray. I just pray.
Please, sir.
When you get really weak, it's hard to be strong. When you're physically weak, it is hard to be strong. That's why we need our brothers and sisters to lift us up and to hold our hands up when we're going through a battle. Yesterday we came up here. I haven't sang since March, really. Since we're here with you, you know, before I got diagnosed.
Mm-hmm.
My voice is very weak. But yesterday we came up here. I said, Lord, I'm alone. Praise you, even in my weakness. The first time I had cancer when I was young, I was like 37, and God told me, he said, he's going to heal me through my praise.
Amen.
And I kept the faith. I kept telling the Lord, stand your ground against the devil. Stand your ground in the Lord. Don't be robbed of God's blessing, because if I'll take it by force.
Yes, Lord.
Tell yourself you're going to make it, and I stand on that. Amen. I stand on that every day. God has been good, and my blood has done really good through all of the chemo. Everything has done. I've been doing better than, you know, there's a lot of people and lots, you know, has lots more problems. And I hadn't had to have a blood transfusion. I hadn't had to, you know. So I'm so thankful for everything. And my blood count for my cancer is at 30, which is in remission.
Praise the Lord.
So 30, 35 and below is remission. And so when I go back this time, I'm praying that it's going to be in the digits or zero. So I'm just so blessed and so thankful that I am in remission, as they call it. And I'm praying, God, I will never, ever have this cancer again. So I'm just claiming the healing.
Amen.
Thank the Lord.
So what would Jesus say? We're going to do the blood of Jesus?
Yes. The blood of Jesus. Talked about it earlier, Pastor.
Amen.
What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can heal my body? Jesus. If you've never had cancer, some serious disease strike in your family, you're fortunate. Most of us, we all know somebody that's had to fight the battle. And we need every one of us. We need each other. We need one another to fight that battle. You never know when it's going to be you that's in the need of prayer.
The blood of Jesus, the blood.
gone too far. You may think there is no power that can wash away your deepest sin. There is hope for you, my friend. Jesus died and rose again so that you could know the joy of sin forgiven.
Precious Heavenly Father, God, as we come to you in prayer right now in the name of Jesus. God, we come to you with prayers of faith and believing. God, knowing without a shadow of a doubt that what our God's able to do. And God, Lord, I believe right now, just like we know that the blood of Jesus, Lord, is able to take care of everything. Lord, just like we know that you're able to take care of the woman with the issue of blood, Father, Lord. God, I believe that you're able to do it right now. God, Lord, if she goes back to this doctor, there'll be an amazement for the doctor. There'll be a wow for them. There'll be a wow for everybody. And there'll be a glory for you, God, because you're going to do it right now in Jesus' name. Father, we're believing it. God, we know that you're able to do it. God, you don't halfway do anything. You do it all the way, completely, utterly, and totally right now. God, I believe it's going to be zero. There ain't going to be nothing there right now. Father, we're trusting you. Lord, I'm giving you praise for it.
Yes,
God, I'm praising you on credit for what I know that you're going to do. Because, Lord, it's by your stripes that we are healed.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
We appreciate them so much. Amen.
You know, Pastor. On the way up here, Rhonda said, "You know, I just thank the Lord for this church in our condition, just to letting us come and sing today, because she needed to see."
Amen.
God gives her when she's praising him. So I just thank you, church. We love you guys. We're going to be seeing a lot of y'all in the future, so
amen.
Don't forget our name. So we're going to be back.
Amen. Appreciate the Lord for that. Psalm number 133 says, "Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity."
Amen.
It is like the precious oil upon the head, running down on the beard of Aaron, running down on the edge of his garments. It is like the dew of Hermon descending upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commanded the blessing, life forevermore.
Amen.
I love what it says in that first part. Behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. And I'm thinking this morning and feeling this morning, we are living in a day and time where there is less unity than there's ever been.
Come on.
We live in a country where there's less unity than there's ever been.
Yes, Lord.
There are houses and homes that there's less unity than there's ever been. There is less unity in the church than there has ever been.
Come on.
We are so divided by either denomination or this little thing that we don't like or what that one doesn't like. When the one thing that should be uniting us all is the blood of Jesus Christ. The one thing that should be uniting us all is being able to say that I'm born again, that I'm blood-bought, and I'm on my way to heaven. And all that trivial stuff really doesn't matter. If we can get past all the stuff and all the things, you like that, the things, of Christianity, and get down to the nitty-gritty of what it means to actually serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy mind, with all thy soul, and to be able to worship him with spirit and in truth, and not be worried about all the silly stuff that we get so caught up in about, and get so frustrated about, and we get mad at this one or that one or whatever. Just quit your complaining and start praying. Amen.
Amen.
We have a tendency that we'd rather, as Debbie talked in Sunday school this morning, we'd rather talk about what leadership does instead of praying for the leadership. We'd rather fuss about what this one does or that one does. Go like this, because